Namaste, I'm Dr. Shashikala Rao. Today's my topic is on Bhava Chali Chart. Bhava Chakra, Bhava Chart, Chali Chakra, Chali Chart. Bhava Chali Chakra are the same, but it is called in different names. Chalit means moving from one point to another point. The planets posited in the Rashi chart appear to move to the previous house or to the next house in the Bhava Chali Chart. There are various types of house division methods are available. Today particularly I am discussing the equal house division. There are two methods of equal house division. In an equal house system, all the bhavas are equal, which means the span of each bhava is equal to 30 degree. In the first type of equal house division, we consider the bhava arambha and bhava antya concept. In the second type of equal house division, we consider bhava arambha, bhava madhya and bhava antya concept. In the first type of equal house division, we consider the longitude of lagna as a starting point of the first bhava. In the second type of equal house division, we consider the longitude of lagna as a midpoint of the first bhava. Today, I am erecting the Bhava Chali Chakra as per the first method and the second method of equal house division and comparing both the methods. Once again, note the difference between the first method and second method of equal house system. In first method, a span of each bhava is equal to 30 degree. Bhava Arambha and Bhava Antya concepts are considered. The longitude of lagna is considered as bhava arambha of the first bhava. In second method, a span of each bhava is equal to 30 degree. Bhava arambha, bhava madhya and bhava antya concept are considered. The longitude of lagna is considered as bhava madhya of the first bhava. To erect the bhava chart, we need a Rashi chart. We construct the bhava chart based on the Rashi chart. So, bhava chart is an additional chart. This is a sample Rashi chart. Make a list of planets with their longitude. In the Rashi chart, the lagna is falling in the Cancer at 29 degree 14 minutes. Now, let us construct the bhava chart as per the first method of equal house system. Condition for the first method of equal house systems are as follows. A span of each bhava is 30 degree. We consider the bhava arambha, that is starting point of the bhava, and bhava antya, that is ending point of the bhava. Also, we consider the longitude of lagna as a starting point of the first bhava or bhava arambha of the first bhava. In the sample Rashi chart, lagna is in Cancer at 29 degree 14 minutes. This is equal to 119 degree 14 minutes. Also, it is equal to 3s 29 degree 14 minutes. In this method, the longitude of lagna as 119 degree 14 minutes becomes the bhava arambha of the first bhava. Add 30 degree to the bhava arambha of the first bhava, it is equal to 149 degree 14 minutes. That means if we add 30 degree to the bhava arambha of the first bhava, we will get the bhava antya of the first bhava and it will be bhava arambha of the second bhava. If we add 30 degree to the bhava arambha of the second bhava, we will get the bhava antya of the second bhava. It is the bhava arambha of the third bhava. Similarly, add 30 degree to the bhava arambha of every bhava so that we get the bhava antya of each bhava. So, we get the boundary of each bhava with its bhava arambha and bhava antya. As per the longitude of the planets, we have to place the planets in the corresponding bhava. The longitude of sun is 28 degree 22 minutes. It falls within the span of 9th bhava. The longitude of moon is 360
59 degree 19 minutes. It falls within the span of 9th bhava. The longitude of Mars is 274 degree 43 minutes. It falls within the span of 6th bhava. The longitude of Mercury is 5 degree 31 minutes. It falls within the span of 9th bhava. The longitude of Jupiter is 203 degree 42 minutes. It falls within the span of 3rd bhava. The longitude of Venus is 58 degree 23 minutes. It falls within the span of 10th bhava. The longitude of Saturn is 254 degree 32 minutes. It falls within the span of 5th bhava. The longitude of Rahu is 105 degree 47 minutes. It falls within the span of 12th bhava. The longitude of Ketu is 285 degree 47 minutes. It falls within the span of 6th bhava. Looking into the bhava Arambha and bhava Antya of each bhava, we have to place the planets in the corresponding bhava. Bhava Arambha and bhava Antya can be marked in the Rashi chart as shown in this table. The first bhava is starting from Cancer 29 degree 14 minutes and ends with Leo 29 degree 14 minutes. The second bhava is starting from Leo 29 degree 14 minutes and ends with Virgo 29 degree 14 minutes. Similarly, you can see the starting and ending points of each bhava in the Rashi chart. Observe the planetary position in the bhava chart. Jupiter is in the 3rd house, Saturn is in the 5th house, Mars and Ketu are in the 6th house, Moon, Mercury and Sun are in the 9th house, Venus is in the 11th house, Rahu is posited in the 12th house. Observe the planetary position in the Rashi chart. Rahu is in Lagna, Jupiter is in the 4th house from Lagna, Saturn is in the 6th house from Lagna, Mars and Ketu are in the 7th house from Lagna, Moon is in the 9th house from Lagna, Mercury and Sun are in the 10th house from Lagna, and Venus is in the 11th house from Lagna. Compare the planetary position in the Rashi chart and Bhava chart. You can find the shifting of planets. Rahu is moved from 1st house to 12th house. Jupiter is moved from 4th house to 3rd house. Saturn is moved from 6th house to 5th house. Mars and Ketu are moved from 7th house to 6th house. Mercury and Sun are moved from 10th house to 9th house. The position of planets in the Rashi chart may appear to move to the previous house or to the next house in the Bhava chart. In this case, 7 planets are moved to the previous house. We can represent the Rashi chart and corresponding Bhava chart. Compare the Rashi chart and the Bhava chart as per the first method of equal house division. We can observe there is a shifting of planets in the Bhava chart. Particularly, in this case, nearly 7 planets move to the previous house in the Bhava chart. This is about the first method of equal house division. Now, let us construct the Bhava chart as per the second method. We are considering the same sample Rashi chart. Condition for the second method of equal house division are as follows. A span of each bhava is 30 degree. We are considering the bhava Arambha, that is starting point of the bhava, bhava Madhya, that is midpoint of the bhava, and bhava Antya, that is ending point of the bhava. Also, we are considering the longitude of Lagna as a midpoint of the first bhava or bhava Madhya of the first bhava. Lagna is in Cancer at 29 degree 14 minutes, that is equal to 119 degree 14 minutes. This is considered as bhava Madhya of the first bhava or midpoint of the first bhava. subtract 15 degree from the midpoint of the first bhava, that is 119 degree 14 minutes. Then this is equal to 104 degree 14 minutes. This is considered as bhava arambha of the first bhava. Add 15 degree to the midpoint of the first bhava, that is 119 degree 14 minutes. Then this is equal to 134 degree 14 minutes. This is considered as bhava antya of the first bhava. So we'll have a bhava madhya of the first bhava as 119 degree 14 minutes. Bhava arambha of the first bhava as 104 degree 14 minutes. Bhava antya of the first bhava as 134 degree 14 minutes. In an equal hour system, each bhava is equal to 30 degree. Add 30 degree to the midpoint of the first bhava, then it becomes 149 degree 14 minutes. It is the midpoint of the second bhava. Add 30 degree to the midpoint of the second bhava, it becomes 179 degree 14 minutes. It is the midpoint of the third bhava. Similarly, we can calculate all other midpoints of the bhava. From the midpoint of the one bhava to midpoint of the next bhava is equal to 30 degree. Subtract 15 degree from the midpoint of every bhava so that we get the bhava arambha of each bhava. Add 15 degree to the midpoint of the every bhava so that we get the bhava antya of each bhava. We can diagrammatically represent the bhava arambha, bhava madhya and bhava antya of all the 12 bhavas. Dotted lines indicate the bhava madhya. So, we get the boundary of each bhava. As per the longitude of the planets, we have to place the planets in the corresponding bhava. The longitude of sun is 28 degree 22 minutes. It falls within the span of 10th bhava. The longitude of moon is 359 degree 19 minutes. It falls within the span of 9th bhava. The longitude of Mars is 274 degree 43 minutes. It falls within the span of 6th bhava. The longitude of Mercury is 5 degree 31 minutes. It falls within the span of 9th bhava. The longitude of Jupiter is 203 degree 42 minutes. It falls within the span of 4th bhava. The longitude of Venus is 58 degree 23 minutes. It falls within the span of 11th bhava. Longitude of Saturn is 254 degree 32 minutes. It falls within the span of 6th bhava. The longitude of Rahu is 105 degree 47 minutes. It falls within the span of 1st bhava. The longitude of Ketu is 285 degree 47 minutes. It falls within the span of 7th bhava. Looking into the bhava arambha and bhava antya of each bhava, we have to place the planets in the corresponding bhava. Bhava arambha, bhava madhya and bhava antya can be marked in the Rashi sign as shown in this table. The first bhava is starting from Cancer 14 degree 14 minutes and ends with Leo 14 degree 14 minutes. The second bhava is starting from Leo 14 degree 14 minutes and ends with Virgo 14 degree 14 minutes. Similarly, you can see the starting points and ending points of each bhava in the Rashi chart. In this equal house system, bhava arambha, bhava madhya and bhava antya concept are considered. Any planets near the bhava madhya are powerful to give the results of the house it occupies. Planets near the bhava arambha and planets near the bhava antya are less powerful to give the results of the house it occupies. Observe the planets which are near the bhava madhya, that is 29 degree 14 minutes. Bhava madhya of ninth house is Pisces, 29 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Moon is posited with its longitude 29 degree 19 minutes. Bhava Madhya of 10th house is Aries, 29 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Sun is posited with its longitude 28 degree 22 minutes. Bhava Madhya of 11th house is Taurus, 29 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Venus is posited with its longitude 28 degree 23 minutes. The planets Moon, Sun and Venus are near the Bhava Madhya, so they are powerful. Similarly, observe the planets which are near the Bhava Arambha and Bhava Antya. In this table, observe the planets which are near the Bhava Arambha, that is 14 degree 14 minutes. Bhava Arambha of the 6th Bhava is Sagittarius, 14 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Saturn is posited with its longitude 14 degree 32 minutes. The difference is only 18 minutes. Bhava Arambha of the 1st house is Cancer, 14 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Rahu is posited with its longitude 15 degree 47 minutes. And Bhava Arambha of 7th house is Capricorn, 14 degree 14 minutes. Near this, Ketu is posited with its longitude 15 degree 47 minutes. The planets Saturn, Rahu and Ketu are near the Bhava Arambha. So, these planets are less powerful to give the results of the house it occupies. Compare the Rashi chart and Bhava chart. You can find the shifting of planets. Mars is moved from 7th house to 6th house. Mercury is moved from 10th house to 9th house. The position of planets in the Rashi chart may appear to move to the previous house or to the next house in the Bhava Chali chart. In this case, only Mars and Mercury move to the previous house. In this way, we can represent the Rashi chart and corresponding Bhava chart as per the second method of equal house division. Compare the Rashi chart and Bhava chart as per the second method of equal house division. We can observe there is a shifting of planets in the Bhava chart. Particularly, in this case, only two planets moved backward in the Bhava chart. This is about the second method of equal house division. Compare the first method of equal house division and second method of equal house division with the Rashi chart. You can find a lot of difference. In the first method, shifting of planets are more than second method. This is about the second method of equal house division. Now compare the first method and the second method of equal house division. You can find a lot of difference. In the first method, shifting of planets are more than the second method. This is depending on the Bhava Arambha and the longitude of the planets. This all about the equal house system. From this, we can find an equal house system is convenient and easy to construct. Some astrologer has the opinion Rashi chart is enough to give the prediction. Some astrologer has considered the Bhava is important. Without Bhava chart, prediction is incomplete. If Bhava is considered, which house system should I use? Which one is more accurate? What works for us? There is no right answer to this question. My request to you, do research. In my next video, I will discuss on Sripati method of Bhava. Thank you. Namaste.